Alright, let's try this again. Isaac crashed on me while I was getting everything set up, but that's probably not a good sign. But here's hoping. I can't see who's in the chat room, by the way, so make sure you let me know if there are issues with the stream, and I will try streaming in a lower bitrate. Alright, Eve, you had your chance. I did get a Satan kill on hard, though. So I did make progress, technically, even though I did not beat the Dark Room. But let's give Maggie a shot. I already beat Satan on hard with her, so it's going to be a Dark Room or bust. Okay. Oh, actually, I'm streaming in the old bitrate again, because it was still set up. It was a different setup for Hitbox. So this should be as ideal a streaming situation as possible, because I'm not on Twitch and I'm only streaming in 1500 kilobits per second. So if you're having issues, then it's gotta be just a problem with the internet. The internet itself is having issues tonight. Maybe I should just start streaming on Steam. I mean, everyone who watches me is on Steam, right? I can just post a notification in the Steam group and say, hey, I'm streaming. Aw, man, I don't want Bomb Spring. I can just post a notification in the group and say, hey, I have my microphone turned on. Come and watch me if you want. Because, I mean, when I'm not streaming on Twitch or Hitbox, I'm always streaming on Steam. I just have that stuff always on, whether my mic's on or not. So it wouldn't be that big of a stretch. I'm assuming that's you, Private Steve, correct? Because you still have the PvP in your name. He says yeah, so I'm not sure that's referring to yeah, the stream looks good, or yeah, the internet's having problems, or yeah, you should just stream on Steam. I should leave that thing alive so I can hit it with Bob's brain and blow that X rock up. Shit. It might be easier said than done. There we go. Aw, man, it's a dumb chest. Oh, that's Oxbow, right, Pierre Kirby? Well, I'm glad you can watch. I'm not sure why you can't chat. It's always something, isn't it? Alright, I should lure these guys in this corner, so I can blow these rocks up and get that pill. Or just blow myself up, you know, either way. Oh, thanks, Oxbow. Great. I love Amnesia. My favorite pill ever. I don't know if you have to have a Steam account to watch someone stream on Steam or not. Wait, that's an awkward phrase, isn't it? Stream on Steam? I should just say broadcast on Steam. Let me check my settings real quick. Okay, I just wanted to make sure my audio settings were still kosher, because I haven't streamed on Hitbox in a while. I was streaming on Hitbox just all the time whenever I was playing a game. And I just wouldn't talk as much. It was more of a chill stream kind of situation. But maybe I'll start streaming on Hitbox full time. I mean, does it look okay for you, Private Steve? Or Private Philip AB? Philip Ab? Shit. And Oxbow, feel free to chime in, you know, by sending me a Steam message. Bob's Rotten Head, eh? Well, I mean, it would be cool to have both the head and the brain, but I'm dealing enough damage to myself with the brain as it is, so I think I'll hold on to VM Heart. Alright. Private Someone is not getting any lag, that's a good sign. I wonder if Hitbox sent out a notification to Twitter when I started streaming. I forget if I had that set up or not. Red Patch. Well, it said your rage grows in the item description. But I'm not sure if that means... Because the red patch, it gives you a chance of, like, turning red and dealing more damage if you get hit, right? Not sure if that's what that means or if they changed the effect. Man, I feel pretty salty about that last run. So close. Hello. Darek Shama? Darek Shama? Long time no see. Did you use a different name on Twitch or something? Because your name is not ringing a bell. I mean, if I forgot you, then I apologize. But that name is not familiar. Or is there a different name you've used in other places, like on YouTube or on Steam or something? Okay, only watched a few times, kept missing the stream. Okay, well, welcome. I'm glad you can make it. And I'm sorry I forgot your name. And sorry I probably butchered the pronunciation. Just a general all-purpose sorry, really. Just a blanket apology. How do I watch stream broadcast? Oh, you mean on Steam? You go to my profile, and there will be a button that says Watch a Game, I think. Or if I'm in your friends list, you can just right-click my name and say Watch Stream that way. But I have it disabled right now because I'm streaming on Hitbox. But yeah, in the future, I mean, probably the easiest way is just if you see me playing a game, just right-click my username and say Watch Broadcast. I think you have to opt in to the beta, but that doesn't mean you have to stream, or that doesn't mean you have to broadcast. You can disable that and just watch people broadcast. I think you might not have to opt into the beta. Not sure if they require you to do that or not. Glad Hitbox seems to be working better though. Unicorn Stump, eh? Well, if I had an item that comboed with it, I'd pick that up, but I do not. Crap. Stupid wizard pill. Oh hey. See those very often? Well, that's one way to avoid blowing myself up with the brain, I guess. Having to shoot in a completely different direction. Aw, it's just a red chest. Kind of underwhelming. I like how when it's 2D like this, you still have a little bit of momentum when you're climbing the ladder. I don't know why. It just kind of tickles me. Whee! Unicorn Stump is never useful when I use it. Yeah, same here. I mean, It'd be really cool if I got Mom's Knife or something, but I've never gotten that combo, so. Not great. See, now that I have Bob's Brain, not only should I not hold the D-pad when I enter a room, I also should not be shooting when I enter a room, because I risk immediately blowing myself up if there's something right in front of me. Or something that jumps right in front of me. Nice. Screw you, Tick. I said I do not want you. It's being trolled by the Tick. Not the good Tick, the bad Tick. Oh, hey, what's up, Twisted Little Heart? Good to see you. Yeah, it would work really well with E. coli as well. Midas Touch, I mean, it'd be okay with Midas Touch, but E. coli would be the best. Because the Midas Touch is kind of temporary. But with E. coli, stuff would just turn into poop. I shouldn't have spent that coin. I should have gone into the item shop. Oh well. Oh wait, there are two locked doors on this level, so I should probably check out both of those. Is this an XL level? No? Just a normal basement 2. Maybe a library or something. Alright, so 5 items, or 6 items, in the shop now instead of... Wait, isn't this... Might have been 5 before, and now it's 6. Yeah, Curse of the Maze is kind of annoying, but I'd rather have that than any of the other curses, to be honest. Well, I guess the Curse of the Labyrinth is the best curse to get, but after that... The maze is probably the least annoying of the curses. Great. I'll go into the item shop if I get another coin. But since I only have 2 keys, not gonna waste one of them on that. Well, I could go looking for the other secret room or blow up that tinted rock if I had bombs, but I do not. Shit. I mean, I have Bob's Brain, but only useful to me if there's an enemy in the room. And of course, I'm not going to get a Satan room because I took a ridiculous amount of damage. Well, yeah, I should probably just save both my keys. Oh wait, that's right, I already got the item shop. So the other thing is going to be the library or the chest room or whatever. I could grab that heart, but no point yet. That's kind of interesting. A tower, a magician, and 2 of clubs. It'll give me 2 bombs so I can get that blue rock, or quote unquote blue rock. Yeah, I think I'll do that. And then I'll take the tower, I guess. Or I could have just used the tower to get the blue rock, because it'll probably blow that thing up, right? Yeah. Nice. Small rock. Alright, go back and grab that other tower card. And I think that there is going to be a secret door right here. Well, well, well. I can buy something from the item shop now. I'll buy the habit. It combos pretty well with my Yum Heart. Now see, in the old Isaac, if you got the habit and the Yum Heart, that would pretty much be GG. Because you can just heal yourself every time you take 2 damage. But it's a little less broken in Rebirth. Using a lot of memes lately, like GG. It's not something I say very often. I said something else earlier that was kind of memey. This is a crappy room. I bet I want to get hit here. Yep. Oh well. Yeah, this is definitely going to be a red heart run, it looks like. With the Yum Heart in the habit. Shit! God damn it, I'm going to have to get so close to this thing. That I blow myself up. Let's see if this works. No. Shit. For God's sake. I didn't know how else to do that. Oh well. At least I have my Yum Heart. I think that's a good item. Makes soul hearts drop more often. Shit. And see those spikes behind my microphone pop filter. Oh, hey, Just Draw, what's up? Yeah, I agree. Fuck Twitch. Seems like I've had nothing but problems with it lately. Of course, it could be better because I'm streaming in a lower bitrate, too. I could have been contributing to it. So, I don't know. I'll have to try Hitbox with the higher bitrate at some point. Now, you see, that'll be the test. If it still works well, even in the higher bitrate, then it is definitely Twitch's fault. I visit with my friend too, and he's on Fios, and he lives about a mile from me. Yeah, it probably is Twitch, actually. Because, I mean, I'm assuming everyone watching this has a better connection than 3 megabits per second, right? Because unless you all have a worse connection than 3 megabits per second, or if you're, like, downloading or uploading something that's using all your bandwidth, that would affect it as well. you do have that bad of a connection, then I feel really bad for you. My internet was recently upgraded. It used to be, last year it was 30 megabits down and about 3 up, and now it's about 50 megabits down and 5 up. For free. It's pretty cool. I have to say, a lot of people can complain about their cable companies and ISPs. Mine is pretty good. I rarely have issues with... They're called Suddenly. They're like sort of local... They're not local. They're in other parts of the country, but they're not as big as like Comcast or Warner or, you know, or Time Warner, all the big cable companies. Yeah, Just Rupp's on 100, and he was having issues with Twitch too, so I'm assuming it was Twitch. The stream is still decently choppy for Twisted Little Heart. That sucks. I wish there was just a solution that works well for everybody. See, I was really stoked when my bandwidth got increased too, because I mean, it doesn't make a huge difference in a game like Isaac, because 2D games don't require a high bitrate to look good. But if I was streaming like Saints Row or Borderlands or something like that, something in 3D with a lot of movement, you know, more movement on the screen than Isaac, then the higher bitrate would help a whole lot in making it not look so bad. Of course, my computer is not really good enough to stream those kinds of games anyway. Like, even with the higher bitrate, I'll still have to turn the quality on the game way down to make sure it doesn't chug. I think when I get my tax refund, I'm going to upgrade my computer. Because my computer, I mean, it's a few years old, but really all I need is a better video card and more RAM. And I'd be fine, because my processor, it's still perfectly adequate. But I think my big bottleneck is only having 4 gigs of RAM. Because my video card isn't horrible. But it could definitely use an upgrade, though. $120 down and $15 up? Good lord. I am very jealous. Yeah, private. My computer, like, it's good enough to play all of my games, but it's not really satisfying having to turn down the quality or turn down the resolution. Because, like, even on a relatively low... A game that doesn't require a lot of resources, like Borderlands 2, even when I wasn't streaming, I still got really shitty frame rate unless I turned it down to 720p. Like, sub 30 even. So, it would be really nice to be able to play games in 1080p and 60 frames per second. Like, that's really what I would, want a PC for, and not being able to get that is kind of disappointing. Oh, data limits. That sucks. Yeah, I'm lucky that they haven't done any sort of data cap or anything with my internet provider. Oh god, I hate this room. I do not like this room one bit. I might just bomb my way out of it. Shit, yeah. I want to do that. Screw that room. I'm optimistic that things will get better, though, because it's only a matter of time until Google Fiber starts expanding their market, right? Once Google Fiber starts putting pressure on on the other internet providers, things will improve, I think. Or if I could just get Google Fiber, that'd be pretty awesome too. I mean, I doubt it's going to come to my area anytime soon, but... I mean, things have to improve eventually, right? I mean, not that my situation is bad, but, like, people dealing with data caps and stuff is no fun. Shit, I shouldn't have gone this way. What's wrong with me? Of course, I have the Curse of the Maze, so I can still get teleported back into that room. Up a little bit. My view keeps getting blocked by my microphone thing. Nowhere near your limit, that's good. I mean, really, people in Canada and Australia have it the worst as far as internet service goes. Because from what I understand, data caps are abundant in Canada and Australia. Alright, nothing in this little corner of the map, so I can just... Shit. I can just, blow my way through here and not have to worry about this room anymore. Make sure I didn't miss anything. Sucks that I had to waste all those bombs, though. Man, more options would be nice. That's worth a shot. Yeah, I didn't think I'd get enough for more options. Well, maybe the boss will drop some money. $5 less than DSL for 10 times the speed. Awesome. Yeah, all of my DSL experiences were pretty bad. Right, this room. Shit. Well, my yum heart is fully charged, so I should be okay. That room sucks. I do not like that room one bit. Nice, that worked out pretty well for me. Shit. Crap. God, I hate boss brain. I would have never picked that item up on purpose, unless I had the pyromaniac item. The only time I would pick up Bob's brain. What the? God, I was so far away from that and the blast radius still hit me. Oh well, at least I have a good combo going on with the Yum Heart and Abbott. That's the one thing I have going for me on this run. Getting hit too much to get any devil rooms. Oh, well. It's a pretty crabby Caves XL. And Curse of the Lost, great. I mean, yeah, Bob's Brain can be useful, but honestly, I just screw myself over with it more often than not. Oh, what the hell? Rona's going south. I have all these heart containers, and I'm not going to be able to get any double rooms. I keep taking damage. I'm not getting any soul hearts. A scapular item did not seem to help me very much. Yeah, exactly. Same here, Private. Bob's Brain sucks. The hell hit me? I guess I walked over the blood, but it didn't look like it. Alright, well, I can go back and get that battery at least. Get another charge. Another heart. Of course, the other downside to using Hitbox is that I can't connect to it with IRC like I was doing with Twitch, which means no chat logs on the videos. I've been too lazy to do that recently anyway, but that was another advantage that Twitch has over Hitbox. I don't think there's a way to do that. I couldn't find. Like, I don't know if Hitbox's chat is hosted on IRC or not. God, these things are the worst. Would have been fuck you. It would have been nice if those bonds were close enough to blow up these fires. Getting the haunt every run, that sucks. The haunt's a really bad boss to get early on. Later in the game he's not such a big deal, but getting the haunt in the basement, ooh, can really spoil a run. Let's try holding on to the sun until the next level. Heal myself up and reveal the map. I think using the sun card or a similar effect should counteract the curse of the lost. Or amnesia or anything else that takes your map away. There should be more ways to deal with the curses in general, I think. Because the only way... That's kind of cool. The only way to deal with the curse... With curses, period... is the black handle. And it makes you immune to curses, which is really nice. But it doesn't show up nearly as often as you would like. Man, if I didn't have this yum heart, I'd be screwed. Probably if I didn't have the habit as well. That is definitely helping me out. So I said in the last stream that I wanted to stream some more stuff that's not Isaac. And that's still true. I would like to vary it up a little bit. But streaming other games, especially blind, can be really stressful. Because, I mean, the Binding of Isaac is a known quantity. Like, I know exactly what I'm going to get out of a Binding of Isaac stream. Whereas if I stream, like, I've been wanting to play the next Shadowrun. I guess it's an expansion? I'm not sure. Dragonfall? The new, well, it's not new. It's about a year old at this point, but I haven't played it yet. The latest release from the Shadowrun Returns people. But I have no idea if that would make a good stream game or not. So, I mean, I like watching people play games blind. I like watching people play RPGs. But I don't know if that kind of thing would be compatible with the way I stream, you know? I do want to try more stuff, but, yeah, that's what I hear, Private. I don't know if it would be fun to watch, though. Even if it is a really good game. They got stuck on each other. That was cool. Oh, grab that. No point in buying the red heart since I have a sun card, and I'm probably going to use it. Ooh, I should get the faster. Oh no, that's the, that lets you hold extra charge. It's not a faster charge. Still be nice to have, though. Not even going to bother looking for secrets because, you know, I don't have a map, so I'll have no idea where I should even try to bomb. Hey, it's Nicolas Cage. What's up, man? I really loved you in that movie you were in. You know, one of the 9 movies you were in this year. Man, Nicolas Cage is kind of a jerk. How easily moddable this game is. I know people were doing some pretty interesting stuff with the original Isaac. Because I would totally mod out the cage and make him look like a Nicolas Cage. I actually got a double room. Oh, and it's Krampus, of course. Just my luck. Get all these freaking hearts, and it gives me Krampus. And it gives me Krampus' head. Great. Don't save on the first fight in the game. Is that in Dragonfall, Private? Or is that the original Shadowrun Returns? The Dead Man Switch. Because I finished Dead Man Switch. I loved it. I thought it was great, and I didn't run into that bug, thankfully. Original? Okay, good. Well, I can pop the sun now, or I can save it for when I've taken damage. Or I can save it for the worm, where having the map would be more useful. I mean, if the last run is any indication, I should probably save the sun card for the dark room. Because, man, if I had the sun card in the dark room on that last run, that would have gone so differently. It makes you unkillable. Oh, well. We certainly don't want that now, do we? I hate it when you open a gold chest and it doesn't even give you money equivalent to a key. It doesn't even give you five coins. That is a negative transaction for opening that chest. I mean, obviously, if you have a whole bunch of keys, it doesn't matter, but when you're running low... I have a pain in the ass. Grab. Shit. I got an eternal heart. That's kind of cool. Tammy's head. It's kind of cool with the rubber cement. Maybe better than the M heart at this point. I don't know. Oh, you didn't notice until halfway through the game? That sucks. Oh, right. Bob's brain. Oh, yeah. Tammy's head with the habit might actually be kind of cool. I kind of like that. I think I'll hold on to this. Unless I just take a ridiculous amount of damage or something. But even then, I have the Sun card. So I can do that once. Now, this is a bad room to fight the Haunt in. Not being able to get beside him kind of sucks. I'll let my attack fly do all the work. Yeah. Oh, so you still took damage. You just couldn't go below one health. Wow. That's annoying. I thought you couldn't even save. I thought the game wouldn't let you save during a fight. I thought it would only save between fights. Now, you see, that's a worthy trade, because I only got 3 coins, but I also got a bomb. And a bomb, theoretically anyway, is equal in value to a key. So that's actually a net gain. Wish all the chests were like that. Oh, you press save and quit by accident, I see. That sucks. I wonder if that's fixed yet. Because I definitely died quite a few times. Oh. In the original Shadowrun Returns. Another Sun card? Really? Oh wait, no. Duh. I dropped that when I picked up the pill. Well, if I get some more keys, I'll check this room out. Come on, Bob's brain. Great. Nice. Kinda wish they stayed on the screen a little bit longer after they bounced, but I guess that would be... That'd be a little broken if they just kept bouncing around. Nice. 3 soul hearts, and I feel protected. I forget exactly which I feel protected effect that is, but I'm happy to have it. I can actually hold on to these soul hearts. Maybe I'll actually get a freaking devil room in the next area. Because honestly, it wouldn't take much to get me to sell my soul at this point, since I have so many heart containers. And my tears suck. So any little upgrade would be most welcome. And I have not gotten very many good pills tonight. Nice. Oh, great. I don't hate greed as much as I used to. I don't know. I guess I've gotten used to his patterns or something. I forget, was there anything good in the item shop? Not the Bible. I should pay closer attention to what the pills do. You don't need the map to be very transparent to be able to see stuff behind it, because all you have to be able to see really is movement. So even a little bit of transparency helps a lot, I think. Yeah, if there's something I could get rid of my red hearts with, then I would totally do that boss challenge run. If there was a blood machine or something. Oh well. A couple keys would be cool. I'd like to see what's in that other locked room. Oh, I won't be able to get there anyway. Never mind. Mom already. Wow. Shit. Theoretically, this is probably the easiest mom to fight. I just need to get her into a pattern where she's stomping a lot. See, I don't want to stay too close to her foot though, because of Bob's brain. So I kind of want to back off a little bit. Shit. And when you back off, it makes it so she doesn't stay in her pattern like that. I guess she doesn't always stay in her pattern anyway. Just, it seems like standing still makes her stomp more often than not. Alright. Really glad you don't have to use a trinket slot to take the Polaroid or the negative. That's definitely a good fix. Okay, well. Would have been nice to get that boss challenge room, but oh well. I'm just going to hold on to my sun card until... Well, there's no point in using it now anyway. But I was going to say either until I take a whole bunch of damage or I make it to the dark room. Stream is working for you now. That's awesome. Glad to hear it. I might just stay with Hitbox forever. I don't know. I mean, yeah, there are advantages to using Twitch, but they outweigh the disadvantages, I think. Or, like I said, maybe I'll just start using Steam Broadcasting. I don't know. Maybe I'll take a poll. Oh, that sucks. Troll spikes. That was the other meme-y thing I said. Talking about trolls. Oh, I guess I should have saved that. For when mom's hand came down. Oh well. Great. The boss is pretty good as an alternative. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I have gotten five of Mom's hands occasionally. Sucks when that happens. I don't know, has anyone watched anyone stream on Twitch on Steam Broadcasting? Because I've had it turned on, but no one's actually watched me or anything. I have no idea how good it is. Like, I looked in on one of my friend's streams where we broadcast once, but they were using a microphone, so there wasn't a whole lot of reason to watch them. Plus, they were playing Dynasty Warriors, which is not a game I am super interested in. Impose gifts in the chat, really? Like, you mean besides the emoticons? Oh yeah, I guess not a lot of people know about Steam Broadcasting yet. I mean, Steam, they didn't really go out of their way to advertise a feature or anything. I think they mentioned it in the Steam news thing, like, once. I mean, it is still technically in beta, so I guess they're not expecting it to be a huge thing yet. But I mean, I don't usually have my microphone on when I'm doing Steam broadcasting, so it's not like I expect anyone to watch me or anything. Hey, that's kind of cool. Alright, so I'll use the Joker, and then I'll probably use the Emperor card right after that. Deal. Oh man, Satanic Bible, that's pretty good. I think I'll take it. Especially with my habit. Oh, if you post a link. Oh, that's pretty cool. No one post any pornography or anything. Resist the temptation. Okay. I just want to fight the boss. Oh, shit. I'll still have to come back for the sun card, though. Oh, well. Dang, I have all this money. Let's see if I can do this without getting hit. Yeah. And that sucks. If a fly spawns and I try to shoot it, I'll probably blow myself up. Hope the human meat does the job for me. Well, this has been the worst slot machine ever. Didn't get anything good until I blew it up. What mic issue, Private? Is there a mic issue with Steam? Great. What even hit me? Didn't see anything. My tears are awful. I'm probably not even going to make it to the dark room, to be honest. Not with this kind of offense. The only offensive item I picked up has been the small rock, right? Well, the brain, but that doesn't count. the fly. The only item that affects my tears that I picked up. Well, I think I got a tears up pill once. But other than that, small rock is pretty much it. Yeah. Well, I have bouncy tears, but that's not really doing a lot for me. Oh, mic was always on regardless of mic settings. Well, that sucks. I bet that would have resulted in some pretty embarrassing situations. Did I go all the way this way? Were there any doors I didn't go in? I forget. I don't think so. Oh, I guess so. Weird how those guts things get stuck like that. Crap. I mean, I don't keep my mic plugged in when I'm not using it, so that wouldn't have really affected me or anything. The one thing I'm not sure about with Steam Broadcasting is that I'm not really sure how it handles things if you alt-tab out of the game or something. I'm not sure if it'll show your desktop or if it'll just like show a blank screen or what. Well, like I said, it is in beta, so hopefully they get all the bugs worked out. I mean, honestly, it doesn't seem like Valve is that interested in Steam Broadcasting anyway. It's just kind of a cool feature that they're like, hey, we can do this, why not? But it doesn't seem like... It's kind of like the Steam Box. Like, it's a cool experiment. It's definitely not their bread and butter. Is that the expression? Not their bread and butter. Like, it's not their... It's not where they make their money. There's an option where it will show your desktop, which people have abused. Oh. Huh. Actually, yeah, I did see that option. I don't know why anyone would do that. Like, why would you stream your desktop? Well, to show porn, obviously. But, like, what legitimate reason would there be to stream your desktop instead of just whatever game you're playing? Like, I don't really get it. Alright. Well, here goes something. I wonder how strictly the Steam Broadcasting stuff is being moderated. Like, I wonder how long someone could get away with streaming porn until... Shit. Until someone catches them. I mean, I guess someone would probably have to report them, because I doubt Valve has people, you know, monitoring all of the broadcasts going on. God, Mr. Fred is giving me issues. That's how you know my build sucks. Mr. Fred should not be giving me issues. great. Hit that thing with Bob's brain. Don't hit the boss. God, that blood stays on the ground way too long. And I didn't even hit him with the brain. Oh, really, Bippo? That sucks. Doesn't seem like there's any streamy option I can go with that works great for everybody. Some people always going to have issues no matter what I use. Sucks. Oh well. Wow, not another curse, really? Seems like every other floor has been a god darn curse. God, I can't even hit stuff with the brain when I'm trying to. Oh, you just want to multitask too much, I see. I don't really do stuff when I watch people stream, usually. Well, sometimes I'll play a game while someone's streaming, but usually I'll just full screen it and sit back on the couch. Yeah, go ahead, Twisted. I mean, I know you're not going to link anything unsavory. Yeah, everyone who's like a regular, feel free to use the gift feature. Because I know you're not going to abuse it. Another stream? What, are you like people in the future and Back to the Future? Just have like 10 shows going on their TVs at once? Or didn't Elvis used to watch TV like that? Like he had 5 TVs and he would watch 5 shows at the same time? I can't even imagine that kind of multitasking. I can barely concentrate on one stream. No, it's just showing me a link, Twisted. Not even a clickable link. You're all of us. I knew it! I knew it, Bippo. Yeah, I mean, I'm not seeing a posted GIF option in the chat, but I have the chat popped out, so there might be more options in the normal chat window. Dang. Yeah, I'm definitely a watch one thing at a time kind of guy. Oh, I only have one coin, so... That's weird. You don't usually see the shell game guy out in the middle of a room like this. Doesn't happen very often. Like, you see the beggar and you see the slot machines, but you don't usually see that guy by himself. You usually only see him in the casinos. I mean, I guess it happens, but it seems like it's rare. Great. There is still a show picture option on the chat settings, huh? Well, maybe they got rid of the feature and they just haven't fixed that in the settings yet. I don't know. Try playing your PC and your 3DS at the same time. Well, I mean, if you're playing like World of Warcraft or something on your PC, you barely even need to play that game. So you can just kind of let it go and play something else on your 3DS. Yeah, like the most multitasking I'll do really is play a game while listening to a podcast or while listening to a stream. And even that, I only do that with a game like Isaac or something. Like, if I'm playing a game where I have to read, I can't listen to something with words at the same time. I don't know. I guess I've always been bad at, like, at splitting my concentration like that. Like, if I'm reading a book, I can't listen to music with lyrics because I can't, like, having words coming in two ways at the same time just screws me up. Oh, you have to be a mod in the chat. Okay, well, I can fix that. Hold on. There you go. Now try it. Oh, and while I'm at it, well, I can't see the chat list, so unless Just Drop says something, I wouldn't be able to mod him. But Bippo, here you go. And oh, okay. Just want to mod you, Just Drop. No worries. I mean, I don't really need moderators because I hardly ever get jerks in my chat, but it's good to have, I guess. Oh, awesome. That's cool. I don't know what that GIF is. For those of you watching on YouTube later, it's a woman talking and blinking, and it says Sydney below her, and she's like a pixelated woman. So that's the GIF that Twisted posted to test the feature. See, that's why you should always come live instead of watching on YouTube later. I'm sorry, I know that's not possible for a lot of you. But that's the kind of exclusive content you miss out on. Shit. Oh my god. How did I not get hit there? What the? I didn't even see that thing. What the hell? Great. God, just let me survive until... Just let me survive until the, until Shale, so I can use my stun card. And actually have it be useful for two things instead of just one. Shit, I knew that was gonna happen. I got way too close to that eye thing. With the brain. Gotta hate Bod's brain. Of course, it is kind of a bummer that I can't see the viewer list on Hitbox. I don't know why that's the case. Never had that problem before. But so far, that seems to be the only issue with Hitbox, so that's good. Also, I don't think Hitbox has ads, does it? I don't know. It's been a while since I've actually watched a stream on Hitbox, but I don't remember ever seeing any ads. Yes, just Rob, except for you. You're the one bad apple. Shit. I guess I might as well hold on to the sun card until I get lower on health. Because who knows, I might survive to the dark room without using it. Not very likely, though. Too many early access? What do you mean? Shit, I better use that now. It was down to one heart. And I went the exact opposite way I needed to go, like always. Great. I haven't played a ton of early access games. The only one I've really spent a lot of time with is Nuclear Throne, I think. Not that I have anything against them. That's just kind of how it's worked out. Wonder if that's out of early access yet. Oh, I did play Paranautical Activity. But it kind of scared me to play that game because it just made my graphics card go freaking nuts. Like, it made my fan just have to constantly, you know, spin as fast as possible. It sounded like a jet. Kind of worrying. Because the last time that happened, it was right before my graphics card died. Screw you, Nicolas Cage. Your movies almost all suck. There, I said it. Gauntlet Throne. The only Nicolas Cage movies I really enjoy are Adaptation and The Matchstick Men. Everything else, you know, I might have fun with it because they're dumb movies, but they're not actually good. Man, he doesn't like that. I made him mad. Face Off. I actually haven't seen Face Off. Is that actually a good movie, or is it a dumb, fun movie? Fucking for Ghost Rider, yeah. That did not look good. In either way. It didn't look good dumb or good. So the stupid "Are you a wizard?" pill. I should just drop that so I don't actually use it. Accidentally use it. I said drop, damn you. Any Nicolas Cage performance is entertaining in its own special way. I don't know. Shit. Oops. I pressed the bomb button instead of the item button. Well, this room blows. Well, I do not have high hopes for this. I was dodging so lightly as well. Or I was dodging so lightly too. It's not really a situation where you would say as well. I probably shouldn't say lightly either. That's not a good word to say. I'm just all about the bad words tonight. Not bad in the seven words you can't say on TV sense. Because I'm always bad about that. Shit. See? One heart. Great. Better be the best dark room, first room in the world. One hell of a tan. I see. God. Screw you. Well, this wasn't the best room in the world. And I don't have the sun card, so I'm pretty much hosed. Yep. It was just a question of how soon I became hosed. Or how quickly. Well. Didn't have any luck with Eve or Maggie. Let's do an Eden run on hard, just to make things interesting. Because I clicked off the thing. Alright, I have the big fat fly, or big beautiful fly. I have the earthquake machine, and I don't have any red hearts. Awesome. And I have the haircut, or the hairstyle of that dude from Far Cry 4. And I have Isaac's pin, or the pin. Tell someone not your friends list. Oh, tell that someone not on your friends list is doing a Steam broadcast. Well, if they haven't turned on, then theoretically they're broadcasting any time they play. Like, when I'm not streaming on Twitch or Hitbox, if I'm playing a game, I'm broadcasting on Steam. So, I mean, if you click on watch stream on their profile, if they're playing a game, they'll be streaming if they have it turned on. If they don't have it turned on, it'll say this user needs to enable Steam broadcasting or something like that. Oh my god, look at my tears. This is awful. This is the worst Eden run ever. I am so dead. I'm gonna have to melee these guys. But yeah, go to their profile and click watch game. And that's the only way. I mean, it would be nice if it would actually tell you if they have Steam broadcasting enabled or not. But it doesn't. It just it always has a watch game button, whether they're broadcasting or not. I was watching a Far Cry 4 stream earlier today. The game actually looks kind of fun. I don't think it would run very well on my computer, though. Like, it sucks, but I'm kind of hesitant to play any, like, AAA big-budget game that came out in the last couple years on my PC, because I can't get a good frame rate and a good resolution. My activated item could have been Yum Heart. Yeah, that would be pretty bad with no red hearts. I like how the piercing tears are actually arrow-shaped. It's helpful. Oh, great! Remote detonation, my second favorite item. My first favorite item being Kamikaze. You'll hold on to my magic fingers. I don't understand the point of this, because I don't know when being able to remotely detonate your bombs would be helpful. Like, at best, it's just a minor inconvenience having to press another button to use your bombs. I mean, I guess it's good. It's good if you need to quickly bomb something, because you make it so it immediately explodes without having to wait for the fuse to count down. But still, it's very situational, and I'm just never in a situation where it's that helpful. Works well with Dr. Fita's bomb tears. Yeah, I can see that. Ooh, nice. An item I don't see very often. Especially not in secret rooms. God, my tears are just a disaster, though. I'm gonna need some tears up items pronto. Nice. I mean, damage up isn't quite as helpful as tears up, but I'll still take it. Oh, hey, didn't see that one. Well, I was really hoping for a devil room, since I don't have any red hearts, but game doesn't want to help me out. Not that I'd want to give up 3 soul hearts anyway, but it might be one of those devil rooms that has an item and 2 black hearts. Those rooms are really cool. Yep, this is totally a melee build. Shit. Man, Unicorn Horn would be pretty cool now. Just ram into things, or a broken Unicorn Horn, just ram into things with my fly over and over again. Well, I took a lot of damage, but probably not as much as I would have taken if I didn't try to melee them. What? Oh. Wait. You have to press it again to activate it now? Or something? Or did it just do that because I got hit? That was weird. Eh, I'll take that. You press and aim. Yeah, that's what I thought, but it didn't work until I pressed the button again. Oh, I see. There's not the delay that it used to have. Okay. That's kind of interesting. Really? Well, not the item I would have asked for. You want me to be totally honest? I would have asked for, oh, I don't know. Odd mushroom. Sad onion. Number one. You know, something to get my fire rate up a little bit. Or, you know, Polyphemus or something would be cool too. If I'm going to fire slow, at least give me a huge deadly tier to do it with. God, look at how long it takes me just to kill fire. That's absurd. Okay, so it doesn't do anything until I press a direction. Okay, that's cool. Easier to use than it used to be, I think. Well, I have kind of a lot of money. And three keys. The disembodied head of Discos too. Yeah, that's pretty good. I wish I had another room so I can charge up my laser again, but oh well. Disco Stew likes disco music. Great. What? I did. Ugh. Alright, come on, Satan. Give me something. None of this stuff is worth 3 soul hearts. Thanks a lot, Satan. I mean, by not taking anything, that means I'm not going to get any more devil rooms, right? Or I'm going to be much less likely to get devil rooms. Anti-grav tears. Oh, did you get that in your game? Well, I didn't mean to take it. I just meant to get close to it, but I guess I got it now. I mean, it's... Oh. Well, that boosts your fire rate, too. Okay. I thought it was just the fear effect. I didn't know it increased your fire rate. Well, that's better than I thought it was. I don't like the anti-grav tears at all. I think it's hard to use, and I don't think there's any point in taking it. Well, hopefully I get some health up, or I get a strength card or something to make better use of future devil rooms. Alright, I'm glad I took that now. I was thinking about taking it anyway. So, it was a happy accident. And I can't see my health, great. That item's kind of good now. I kind of like it. Way better than freaking Krampus's head, because it only takes 2 rooms to charge. Krampus's head just takes a ridiculous amount of time to charge, otherwise it would be sort of useful. That's cool. Homing fear shots. Yeah, I never take the anti-grav tears. I don't know though, it might combo with brimstone or something. In an interesting way. Like, I'll only take the Ludovico technique if I have brimstone. Anti-grav tears might have a similar thing going on. Well, I think in this instance I'd rather have Shoop-de-Whoop. If there's any way for me to broadcast on both Twitch and Hitbox at the same time, now that I have enough bandwidth to do that. Probably not, but that would be really cool. So, like, people can still find me on Twitch, and then if it's not working, then they can go to Hitbox. Oh, you can? That's awesome. I should experiment with that. Do you know whether OBS does that? Because that's what I use. As easy as having 2 OBS open. Wouldn't that affect the performance of my computer though? Because it would technically be encoding the stream twice, right? Well, I mean, I guess that's the only way that would work. You would have to... Why didn't this one blow up? I got robbed. Yeah, I'll have to experiment with that. Because, I mean, it wouldn't be worth it if it makes my computer chug. I mean, it would be nice if OBS could just encode the stream once, and then send it to two different locations, you know? Like, it encodes it into the 1500 bitrate, and then it just sends that both to Twitch and Hitbox. I could do Steam broadcasting and Twitch, or Steam broadcasting and Hitbox. Well, no, because that would still be encoding it twice, though. I don't know. How to stream to Twitch and Hitbox simultaneously. Oh, cool, thanks. I'll take a look at that. I mean, it's definitely worth a shot. And if it makes my computer chug, then... oh well. Damn it. The game always does this. It gives me the blank card when I don't have any cards and there are no cards on the level. There's a card generator in the item room, but I can't afford it yet. God, is it worth using a bomb and spending all that money just to see if the blank card is worth it? I guess so, because I just did it. Two of diamonds. Well, it would be interesting to be able to double my money every four rooms. But I do like having Shoop the Whoop as well. Now see, if it was a Hierophant card, then I would take the blank card in a second. Because two soul hearts every four rooms is just amazing, especially when you don't have any red hearts. Alright, well. Go ahead and just hang on to it and use the two of diamonds twice, I guess. Then I can at least make my money back. Wait, where was it? Oh, I guess it was down here. But yeah, I mean, that would be cool, but it's not worth giving up Shoop the Whoop. So that website you linked to, Darna, does it say whether it'll actually encode the video once or twice? Because if you can do it with OBS without double encoding the video, that would be awesome. I took a lot of damage to the stupid boss, and I don't like it. Stay the hell away from me, stupid flies. Of course. Man, I was all set to give up the heart I just got, too. Well, at least give me coal. You asshole. It just links on tutorials how to do it. Okay, well, I'll take a look at it later, then. God, Krampus is such a jerk. Goat hoof. Well, I'll hold on to this even though I haven't found any block chests since I picked it up. Because I think that'll be more useful to have. I might try for the chest on this run. Since I need to be both the chest and the dark room on hard with Eden. Come on! God, I hate these things. Man, someone made this item sound pretty good. I think I'll hold on to it. Because it makes gold chests spawn more frequently. And then I'll just pick up the the lockpick and just open all these old chests. If I can get lucky enough to have some drop. I'll save my laser for whatever the next boss is. Because it might be Peep or something. Oh fuck, I didn't even see that there. What? Ugh. Why are they so dark? Those little egg sacs. You can't freaking see them in this room. I guess that's why he does it. See, I didn't even freaking see that thing. Yep. What'd I tell you? Peep. Well, at least I'm not down to my red heart yet. Or half a red heart. Oh my god. Oh, now I'm down to half a red heart. Well, that was worth it, he said with much sarcasm. Oh, no gold chest yet. Mass enemy slowdown. Eh. Still rather have the Shoop. It tells OBS to send it to your computer and then to both Twitch and Hitbox. So it sounds like it just encodes it once and then sends it out. That's cool. That would definitely be ideal.
Oh, great.
I knew I should have picked up a heart before I came in here. Well, hell. Well, this looks promising. Light and the red candle. I don't know what the red candle does. And a good pill right off the bat. I'm kind of a dorky looking haircut now, though. Well, the pagan men haircut is pretty dorky, too. Looks pretty similar to the blue candle. Oh, but the flame stays. That's interesting. So it's a blue candle, except that the flame stays on the screen. That's really cool. Thanks, Darak, for the condolences. That's really nice. It looks like it shrinks when it hits enemies, though. But still, I mean, it's better than the blue candle, and the blue candle is already pretty freaking good. I'm gonna be constantly paranoid that it's gonna hurt me, though. Oh, there's a pot there. Toxic aura tears. Maybe my tears are way bigger, too. Seems like my range is worse, though. And my shot speed seems a little worse. Well, I don't know. Those might be about the same. Guess I should get that chest. I don't like how that... how the toxic aura thing makes your mouth look. It looks really gross. It looks like a, one of those deep sea bottom feeder fish. Like an angler fish or something. Really gross. My tears seem to have, the spectral effect too. Didn't realize that at first, but they seem to be going through stuff. Man, this is going to be so good against bosses. Especially the stationary ones. Sit there and let me burn you. Oh, fuck off. Damn it, I lost my Eternal Heart. They also seem to be piercing tears, which is weird because they're not arrow-shaped. But having piercing and spectral tears is pretty nice. Oh, damage up, that's pretty good. Oh, no devil room. Oh well. I actually look forward to them now. Now that I'm using them more effectively. Or maybe spectral tears always pierce enemies as well. I forget. I thought it was one or the other though. Not both. Definitely feel better about this than my last run so far. Oh. Wait, what the heck? Why can I not hit these things? What? What? That's weird. Let's exit the game and continue, see if that's a bug or something. I don't know, Private. That was really weird. Where the hell did those things come from? Well, I'm glad I had the option to quit and continue. Otherwise, I would have sucked. That was a really, really weird glitch. See, I thought I killed everything, and then I saw those boils up in the corner. I was like, WTF. Great. Yeah, me either, Private. I'll have to Google that afterwards and see if anyone else has run into that. I mean, it's not a huge deal since it fixed it when I just quit and continued. But. And if that didn't work, I could have just bombed my way out of the room. So it wasn't like a game-ending glitch or something. Just really weird. Nice. Oops. Yep. Can't shoot that through rocks. Tried to blow that thing up near that tinted rock. Nah. Probably not gonna work. Oh well. OP fire is OP. Yeah, I agree. That is pretty nice. Another freaking curse. Oh god, I wonder if these things are going to be immune to my fire. Since they're already on fire. Nope, doesn't look like it. A room full of those things is kind of scary though. I kinda wish the fire that you spawn is a different color. I mean, I know it doesn't look like the other fire. It doesn't look like these fires because it doesn't have the wood underneath. But, I mean, if you're not paying close attention, it can still be kind of worrying. That's a good one. Damage and HP up. Oh, you got that from a box? That sucks, Private. I feel like a drill sergeant or something. Sorry to hear that, Private. Now drop and give me 40. It's just Private. Philipab doesn't roll off the tongue quite as easily as Private Steve. But that's okay. I don't, you know. Not like I should have any say in what you want to call yourself. That's fighting fire with fire. Get it? Oh, I see. That's okay. No worries. I'll just call you Private and sound like a drill instructor. I didn't see the troll bomb when I was looking at the chat. Stupid mushrooms. Messing up all my all my plans. Really bad at making up names in MMOs. Yeah, I kind of suck at names too. Like, I almost always just use Duke. Or if I'm playing a female character, I'll use Duchess. Pretty much it. Not that I play MMOs. I was playing an MMO, I couldn't just call my character Duke, because I'm sure there would already be a Duke. I got the item room, right? Yeah. Pretty shitty chests. I mean, if I was playing an MMO, I'm sure I could just use Duke of the Bump. Unless there's some jerk out there sniping my name on MMOs I'll never play. Because Phil is a used name, I put AB at the end of Philip. Well, makes sense. Or is that ab? It might just be like abdominal muscles and not like the initials. Screw you. Not gonna be here. Probably try the other wall in this room. Oh, that's a pretty good secret room. There are two or three hearts on the map, so I'm gonna go ahead and see what's in here. Oh, screw you. Oh, I have to kill them before I can leave. God, where's pain room ever? Get a soul heart and immediately have to lose half of it. Range up. That's pretty good. I actually need more range. Fuck this game sometimes. Yeah. There definitely are times where you just get screwed and there's not much you can do about it. Huh, this is an interesting room layout. I don't think I've ever seen this before. Or maybe I have seen it, but I couldn't fly, so I didn't take note of it. Well, hell, those might be really awesome items, but I'll never know. Alright, so I can use the blood machine 3 times. Three runs in a row with a haunt on the first floor. That sucks. Nice. Very nice. That's four more shots with the blood machine. Hopefully I'll get a blood bag. I don't know how people get just insane streaks. Like, I was watching a guy stream this who was doing hard runs with Eden, like I'm doing now, and he got a streak up to 80. And I'm just like, I have no idea how you do that, because you're going to get screwed at some point during that run. Like, no matter how good you are at dodging, at some point, you're going to get a run that's just impossible. Like, you're going to spawn in with, like, one soul heart and tears that barely work, and... like, I don't know how he does it. Fuck you. Fuck you. God, I hate every form of Gertie in this game. I hate Gertie. I hate Gertie Jr. And I hate Mama Gertie. I don't know if the Gurglings are like a version of Gertie or not. They look pretty similar. One's got a dollar in the last area. Yeah, that's happened to me. That is very frustrating. Right, well, I got the strength card, so if I can actually get a devil around, it might be helpful. It'd be kind of hard to hit stuff with a candle. Definitely a little bit of luck involved with it. Hey. Piercing shots. I think I already had that, but thanks. I like the look of the piercing shots. The way they're arrow shaped like that. Shitty pill pool. Like, all night. I've not gotten a good set of pills in any of these runs. Oh, screw you. Might as well use that now. No point. Usually there's no point in hoarding the two of clubs or the two of spades. Because, I mean, there's always going to be a better card to take. Well, usually. If I didn't have the strength card, I might have held on to it, but... glitch in the run that took away Eve's starting item. Wow. See, it's really weird that I ran into that glitch, because up until that point, I've had zero glitches in this game whatsoever. Like, everything has run pretty much perfectly the whole time. And now you're saying that you encountered a glitch, so... this game is not as perfectly coded as I thought it was, I guess. I mean, it's still really good, because that's still only a couple glitches in a very complex game, but I guess nothing's perfect. Thank you. And all of a sudden, I just have an insane amount of money. Alright, secret room is definitely not here, because there's no way I can get to it from this room. Well, I wouldn't be able to get there if I wasn't flying, so it's probably over here somewhere. I like saving the bigger rooms for last, because they're always the biggest pain to deal with. Usually, anyway. I wonder. Nope. That would have been pretty convenient, because I could have just bombed my way into the pain room. But, oh well. That sucks. Actually, I did have a crash earlier between the Twitch stream and the Hitbox stream, so I don't know. Like, today's the first day I've ever encountered any problems with this game at all. Candle, Mega Fatty. There you go. Nice. Man, that disappears pretty quickly when it's on an enemy like that. But still pretty cool. Well, no devil room still. Oh well. Evil up, that's pretty good. Might have a better chance of getting devil rooms now. So I'm gonna go grab this heart real quick. I bet the secret room is between that one room and the boss room. No? Can't be there either. Huh. I have no idea where it is then. Unless it's right here. Guess I might as well buy that bomb. Hey. Hey, let's blow some of these mushrooms. Hope for a power-up mushroom. Gears up? Nice. Speed up? Okay. Well, this is a better pill distribution than the previous runs, that's for sure. Do that again. Give me some more of that. Oh, nothing. Didn't get this one, that's weird. Well, I guess magic can't happen all the time. And I'll buy that key, because why not? Well, my pills are definitely my tears are definitely way better than they were before. That was well worth it. And Curse of the Lost, amazing. You just can't give me a floor that doesn't have a curse, can you? Oh god, that was close. Shit. Well, this will end up being worth it. two soul hearts. That's pretty good. I'm glad that hurts them and doesn't just set them on fire. And I have two ways to deal with you guys. My piercing tears and my holy flame of death. Well, it's a red candle, so I guess it's an unholy flame of death. Oh, I can actually shoot this fire to make it go away too. That's weird. I mean, I guess it makes sense, but I wonder why I would want to do that. Piercing shot is a pretty good way to deal with Larry. Nice. More damage. Definitely welcome. And look at the size of my tears now. That's awesome. Oh god. How did... That was weird. It's like I was immune for a second because I was about to use the candle. But not really. God, I hate amnesia. I can never remember where I've already been. Let me go this way. Okay. Nothing here. So, I've already been down here, right? Yeah. Looks like it. Well, I didn't explore everything down here, I guess. Eh, I would bomb those, but I'm down to my last... Shit! My last two bombs, oh my god. I did not need to take that damage. That was 100% my fault. What is that, mom? Is that mom's eye or Polyphemus? Because if it's Polyphemus, I don't want it. I think when it has the eyelashes like that, it's mom's eye, though. God, I hope that's just mom's eye. Yeah, okay. So apparently, your luck stat actually affects how often you shoot from the back of your head like that. And if your luck's high enough, you can actually get 100%. So... with sufficiently high luck, every single time you shot, you shoot from both the front and the back. Kinda cool. Your luck stat affects a lot of stuff that I didn't think it affected. Like, there are a lot of items where your luck stat makes a big difference in how they work. I used to think it was just slot machines and pills was all it affected, but... definitely affects more than that. A lot of the tier effects, yeah. I could get more pill rune. I mean, I do have kind of a lot of money. This depth's... Okay, depth's one. So, one more floor where... Oh, great. Two amnesia pills. How did you know? Shit. I can pick up the piggy bank. But I won't really need money after this point. I'll donate some money, but I'll save 15. Because there's going to be at least one more item shop. Well, there's going to be one more item shop. No more than that. I just noticed there's like a meat boy and a bandage girl on the shelf in the item shop. That's kind of cool. And a Steven. I wish I could buy these things. Come on, shopkeeper. Why would you display them if they're not for sale? You tease. Sorry, I'm not very talkative at the moment. I've just been streaming for a while and I've kind of run out of stuff to say. It's a very satisfying sound. That rapid fire pop, pop, pop. I mean, I guess I might as well just use the amnesia pill because I already don't have a map. I don't know why I'm dropping them. Pretty nice little amount of damage there. Or not little. Wait. What happened to my strength card? Did I drop it somewhere? Shit. If I leave the room, the devil room will probably go away. I must have swapped it out for a pill and forgotten to pick it back up. Shit. Oh well. Nothing I can trade a heart for in this room anyway. Great. Well, let's go see if I can find my strength card because I have no idea where I would have set it down. And without the map, might not be the easiest thing to find. Okay, didn't drop it in here. Might have been on a previous floor, actually. I haven't been paying super close attention to my pill/card slot. Man, that weird whispering in the background in this music. Really kind of unsettling. Oh, I guess it's gone. That sucks. Oh well. Not like the game's gonna give me a good devil room anyway. I think if you already have amnesia, the amnesia pill should turn into like a memory recovery pill or something. It just sucks that there's no way to ever get your map back except getting the dark handle. All that coming. I guess I should kill these fires. Sometimes they drop soul hearts. Not killing them is just laziness. Wait, is there another soul heart back here that I didn't see? Oh yeah, huh. Oh, thanks, Durok. I could be bombing these skulls too, because they drop soul hearts sometimes, but not very often in my experience. Well, the secret room is definitely not in either of those obvious locations, because it wouldn't be accessible. Yeah, it wouldn't be accessible from this room at all, either side. It might be over here, though. Nope. Well, worth a shot. Alright. Fire can't go through objects. Lame. Yo, it can't go through objects. My tears. Alright. I want to use the heck out of this thing. Is there a bunch of hearts on the map? I like how even with the new music, they kept an 8-bit kind of theme for the arcade. It's a good decision. Is that a new pill? Hey, look at that. Yeah, it is. Luck up, nice. It looks like I hit the 100% rate from Mom's Eye. That's pretty cool. Look at that. Every single shot. My luck must be, well, my luck isn't even that high. I guess it doesn't take much luck. I should have done that boss challenge room before I picked up the blood bag. Oh well. There might be a secret room here. Oh yeah. Stupid rocks. Oh well. Might not be able to shoot fire through the rocks, but I can take cover behind them. Surprised I haven't gotten any dice recently. I have a bunch of the dice unlocked. I have the D20, the D10, the D4, and the D6 unlocked. Everything but the D100, I think. But none of them are showing up. The only reason I thought of that was because I saw a run where a guy abused the hell out of the D20 by using it in a greed room, and all of the coins that dropped turned into other items, and he kept charging the D20 up and doing it over and over again, and he just filled the room with a ridiculous number of items. He was trying to crash the game, but even with a ton of items in the room, like, it was just an absurd number of items, the game didn't crash. Old Isaac would have crashed in a heartbeat. PhD? Oh, that's pretty nice. Better pills. Bombs are key. No. Actually, I think I will use that bombs are key. And bombs is better than 7. And my last coin into the slot machine. I'm going to use this telepills in the pain room, because I can get in without taking damage and then teleport out. And I might teleport into the boss challenge room. That'd be cool. Nope. Oh well. Alright, I don't want to jinx it, but this might be the best run of the night so far. I have a lot going for me. It's kind of ironic that Mom's Eye makes you much more effective against Mom. Well, would be more effective if those doors would actually open. But since it's the red version of Mom, it's not working as well as it could. Oh wait, I have an I Can See Forever pill. I didn't even notice that. Don't remember when I picked that up. Oh well. I'll use it in the next area. Now I still need to beat both the chest and the dark room on hard with Eden. So I'm gonna do a chest run since I haven't done a chest run yet tonight. Oh, this might be worth it. Hey. Pretty good. I missed. Nice. I feel pretty effective this run. Not the best room to use the candle in, but oh well. That's probably better than the poop at this point. Having the rage effect would be pretty nice. That would be better than the poop at this point. It's one of the many great sentences this game makes you say. Oh, you can't even... Can you not burn poop with the candle? That's weird. I think you would be able to. Since you can burn fire with the candle. And poop burns a lot more easily than fire does. Trust me, I know from experience. Trying to burn fire does not work very well. You jerks. Oh, that's right, I can hold 2 pills. I forgot about that. I must have picked up the I Can See Forever at some point, and it just went into my other slot. now. Well, I picked the wrong direction. What a shock. See, having bombs or key stockpiled is pretty good, because I'm not going to need... Oh. I'm not going to need keys after this point, so... Once I run out of bombs, I can just turn my keys into more bombs. I should have used my candle to fight that doppelganger. I don't know what I was thinking. Oh man. Broken remote would actually be kinda cool with the candle. Well, it would make my candle useless, but it would make it so I can just teleport or keep teleporting until I get to the boss room. Of course, it's not an instant teleport. See, the broken remote is awesome if you have like the How to Jump book. Because you can just teleport over and over again until you hit every room you want to hit. So, like, if I wasn't at the boss room, I would have to wait for my candle to charge up, unfortunately. But then I could just keep teleporting. I don't know if I want to hang on to it or not. Well, the Samson's Lock. Well, see, it sucks because I can't actually use the candle now. Because every time I use it, I teleport. See? But I can get the top secret room now, so that's good. Shit. I don't know, I think I would prefer the ability to actually use the candle. So yeah, I should go back and... Well, I guess I could just drop the broken teleporter. No, well, there are hearts up there I want to get anyway, so... Let's be prudent. Now, if I had how to jump, I would definitely use that combo, because you can teleport out of a room instantly, as soon as the monsters spawn. So you don't have to worry about anything. Just keep teleporting until you get to the boss. Really. If I was on the lower levels, then I can just keep teleporting until I get to the item shop, and then the item room, and then, you know, any other room that I wanted to go in, and not have to fight enemies in any of them. Well, except for, like, the boss room, obviously. I could use the broken I'll do that one thing. I'll go to the pain room with a broken teleporter and teleport out. Two guppy items this late in the game. Oops. Well, shit, now I have to go back in and get my candle. And then take damage on the way out. Oh, wait, no, I don't. I still have the broken teleporter. I'm a dummy. Alright, grab Samson's Lock. And fight the boss. Still just Utero 1, so... No, it lives just yet. Ball of tar and sticky sack. How does that work? Well... You have two things that can slow enemies, right? Sounds like they would combo pretty well together. Thank you. box of stuff. I'm glad I got that PhD. It's been working well for me. Alright, so I can see forever and bombs are key. I'll keep one of each. The sticky sack spawns spiders, and the ball of tar makes some of your tears slimy. Right, so... Oh, okay. You're just explaining that. The sticky sack also leaves a trail behind it that slows enemies, right? Arcade? I'll check it out. After the secret room, hey. I don't know if I should give this guy my keys or hang on to them and turn them into bombs later. Well, I'm not fighting Satan, so I probably won't need a ton of bombs this run. And one more guppy item, and I'll be in really good shape. Probably not very likely, but you never know. Well, I could give him 18 more keys if I got rid of all my bombs. But let's see if I get anything from this room first. What the hell is that painting on the wall? Up above me. Looks like some kind of angry clown. With a really bad 5 o'clock shadow. Oh, that's right, you have two different colors of trails. That's kind of cool. Hour energy and bombs are key. Neither of them really do a lot for me. Yes! Oh my god, thank you. I'm guppy now. Excellent. Well, I guess I don't need to give this guy any more keys. I wonder if I should use this. I probably should, right? Yeah, I'll use it a couple of times. There we go. Nice, look at that. Samson run is going well, that's good. I like Samson, he's not my favorite character, but... he's probably in the top three. Probably goes Azazel, Isaac, and then Samson. Well, Isaac once he gets the D6 anyway. Before that, he's kind of useless. Feeling good about this run, guys. If I somehow manage to screw this one up, then you should probably just unfollow me. Because I'm like the worst person in video games ever. God, I love Guppy. I'm sorry I said that the mulligan was as good as Guppy, because it's really not even close. Wait, I don't want this stupid faith bead anyway. What'd I get rid of? Oh yeah, that's right. Samson's locker, whatever. I don't know how much that would help me. So, I'll keep Pinky Eye. At least when Pinky Eye does something, I know it. Fuck off. Oh well. That went okay. I still took more damage than I would have liked, though. Oh, great. This Curse of Darkness. Freaking awesome. The other day, I got Curse of Darkness in Shale, which sucks because it's impossible to see anything because Shale, the color palette, is already so dark. With the Curse of Darkness, it's just so much worse. I ended up turning up the brightness on my TV. Just kind of sad. I want to hang on to my bombs or key pill from when I get to the chest. Give myself enough keys to open everything. Shit. If I get to the chest, that's kind of cool. It makes my tears, or the arrow tears, way wider. Take that. I say as I pick up the other thing. That looks kind of cool with the arrow-shaped tears, but I'll keep the flatworm. And Sheol, it's the Curse of Doom 3. Yeah, exactly. You don't get a flashlight. What's that? A locked door? In the cathedral? It must be something pretty special. Holy crap. That was helpful. I still want to hang on to my candle though. Although passing up the Satanic Bible and the Book of Revelation, it's pretty tough, but they charge so slowly. I don't know, but the candle is probably more useful at this point. Oh yeah, that's a good point. It's God pointing a flashlight at you. Thank you. I should probably be looking for secrets, right? I didn't use an I Can See Forever pill on this level, right? Right. Already bombed right there, so it's probably not there. I'm gonna check over here. But I'm not gonna go out of my way or anything. Nope. Okay. The difference between the red and blue candle. With the blue candle, the flame doesn't stay on the screen. It just immediately goes away. Like, if I use the blue candle, they're just fire and then kind of disappear instead of hanging around. Other than that, they're exactly the same. I guess I could go into the pain room and then teleport out. Of course, who knows where I would teleport, though. It would probably not be convenient. You have to put more effort into getting the blue candle than the red. I'm not sure. I don't remember how you unlock the blue candle or the red candle. Isn't the blue candle, like, donating a certain amount of money? I forget. I don't know. Oh, fuck you. I didn't get hit. I'm still not good at knowing where to stand when he does this attack. Like, logically I know where to stand, but I'm not always thinking logically during this fight. Alright, well, that went extremely well. I don't think so, Twisted. I might be wrong. Nice. Traded my bombs for keys and immediately got 99 more bombs. This is a pretty good chest. Definitely keep the candle, though. You know, I probably should have taken the Book of Secrets instead of the candle, because it would have been more useful to know exactly where the boss is than to keep the candle. Oh well. Man, this music is hardcore. Didn't realize how hardcore this music is. Yeah, I don't know, Twisted. Loss is freaking out because of my scapegoat. That's kind of handy. Does nothing but draws fire. Yeah, I like the scapegoat. It's a good addition. Shit. Well, shit. What do you guys think? Should I fight Mega Satan? I mean, I have to show him off on stream at some point, right? This is probably a bad idea, but here goes. This is the quote-unquote true final boss of the game. Thanks, Private. I mean, it's not really the true final boss of the game, because you don't really unlock anything or get anything for beating him. It's just bragging rights. It does get you the last ending, though. But I guess that does make him the true final boss. Technically. Can't do anything when he's up there like that, though. Until you kill the stuff he spawns. The only times I've ever killed Mega Satan is when I've just been ridiculously overpowered. So, I don't feel great about my odds. But I want to shut up and fight him. Oh, this is the worst part. I hate fighting these angels. Not dead yet. Also, no life bar, by the way, in case you didn't notice. This is a very tense fight. Yes! Oh man. There you go. The true final ending of the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Kinda lame, to be honest. It's just the same thing over and over again. It doesn't really give you any information or anything. But I feel pretty good about that. Honestly, I was feeling a little bummed about the stream, but I ended up killing Mega Satan. Isaac was a demon all along, yeah. I guess that's what that ending means. And yeah, that's what shows up on the file screen when you kill Mega Satan. So yeah, man, this has been a long stream. Thanks everyone for hanging out. I'm glad Hitbox kept working okay. Thanks, Oxbow. Good to know you're still watching. Good to see everyone. Thanks for hanging out, Twisted, Sarah, if you're still watching, probably not. I don't think he came to Hitbox, but Private Steve / Philip Ebb, thank you. And yeah, definitely going to do this again soon, possibly with a different game. Didn't get the chat to work, that sucks. Well, thanks for watching anyway. Appreciate it. So yeah, the Hitbox experiments seem to work pretty well. I'm going to look into streaming both on Twitch and Hitbox, because if I can do both without compromising my computer's performance or anything, that would probably be the ideal solution. But yeah, add me on Steam if you want to watch me broadcast even when I'm not actively streaming. I keep it turned on pretty much all the time, so just Duke of the Bump on Steam, and join the Steam group if you haven't already. Anyone watching this, you get notifications when my stream goes live, so that's nice. Oh, we weren't already friends, Private Steve? Huh. Thanks for adding me. And thank all of you for watching on Hitbox and or YouTube. Bye.